Hi everyone, I'm Wafa Lango and welcome you all in Grammar in Detail. We are going to start the next structure that is known as could have plus third form from active voice into passive voice. Structure, their detail we will be learning in next topic as I told you when we will start structures. But here structure is one when two, three words are combined and they are formalized and structurized, that is known as structure. Formula based, clear? And here we will discuss today the structure could have plus third form from active voice into passive voice. Now you know could have plus third form from active voice into passive voice we will be discussing. Could we have, you can say that it is the, you know, past perfect of the could. Could is, as I told you, used for, you know, present as well as past in secondary level. But when it is used for past present, it will be you know 40%, and could have is more polite way than can. Could is more polite than can, but could have can be the past of the could, like could have. What are simple sentences? Those sentences which make simple statement are called simple sentences. And in active voice, as you know, the subject is the doer of an action. In passive voice, subject is affected, and when it is affected, it is not called object, it will be called agent. Because we have learned when this subject takes the place of object, there it will be called agent, not the object. Agent, it tells us who does an action. And when this object takes the place of subject, there it will be called the title subject or the topic subject which we are talking about. Now, formula in active voice, subject could have plus third form, object full stop. In passive voice, subject could have been plus third form by agent and full stop. Now, example is, they could have cleaned the room. The room could have been cleaned by them. I could have ignored them. They could have been ignored by me. Negative sentences, those sentences in which we deny the statement, reject the statement and refuse the statement are called negative sentences. They could not have cleaned the room. Room could not have been cleaned by them. I could not have ignored them. They could not have been ignored by me. Interrogative sentences, those sentences in which we ask question and put queries are called interrogative sentences. Could they have cleaned the room? Could room have been cleaned by them? Could I have ignored them? Could they have been ignored by me? Formal sentences, those sentences in which we ask question and deny the statement, and we ask them in a formal way, polite way, respective way, and we use it with our elders, that is known as formal sentences. Could they not have cleaned the room? Could room not have been cleaned by them? Could I not have ignored them? Could they not have been ignored by me? Informal sentences is the last formula. What are informal sentences? Those sentences in which we ask question, deny the statement, and we ask them in a informal way are called informal sentences. We use it with our juniors, youngers, and with friends in friendly atmosphere. When could not come together, we change could not into couldn't. Then sentence will be like this. Couldn't they have cleaned the room? Couldn't room have been cleaned by them? Couldn't I have ignored them? Couldn't they have been ignored by me? So these are the sentences of, you know, could have plus third form from active voice into passive voice. Hope you got today's lecture. Subscribe the channel, press the bell icon for more videos. See you next time with next lecture. Goodbye.